With four different looks, many dishes he cooks. New veggies you find, he'll use them for grind. All dishes quite nice, they're better with spice. Among Worley's biological traits, his big stomach is what stands out the most. Yet just because he eats many things, doesn't mean he eats anything. In fact, he will refuse anything not cooked out of the pot, no matter how beneficial. Furthermore, eating same dish in 2 days time frame is something he truly dislikes, so much that he intentionally chooses to take in less nutrition. The more he has to do this, the less he enjoys, and fine meatball can be reduced to a dish no better than 2 cooked berries. So in Survivor's perspective, he is meant to die. But fortunately, this isn't too hard to manage. The moment Worley joins, he has enough calories to last more than 2.5 days, even with his 20% faster hunger drain. This should give enough time to search various ingredients. If satiating hunger is what matters, meatballs should be the first dish, using 3 vegetables he already has and a morsel from an unfortunately stupid soul. Other than that, he could serve himself meals made with ingredients easy to gather, which include ratatouille, butter muffin, fistful of jam, kebab, froggy bunwich, fish sticks, and turkey dinner. If you're quite confident hunter, add meaty stew on the list. This is quite feasible method to abide by until you secure more stable methods to gather different ingredients. In fact, once you manage to start proper farming, you'll be able to grow following 6 vegetables that are newly included as well. With asparagus, onion, garlic, tomato, potato, and pepper, Worley will give meals never existed before using his trusty pot. To briefly explain this portable kitchenware, this can cook all dishes 20% faster than regular crockpots. It can be crafted at reasonable price, and can be placed quite closely with other structures, allowing more compact kitchen. More importantly though, Worley exclusive dishes can only be cooked using this portable pot, which can only be handled by the chef himself. That is perhaps for the best, since many of his dishes are remarkable yet bizarre. Fine example being Grim Galette made with nightmare fuels. More specifically, this pie is made of nightmare fuels, onion, and potato. This delightful treat swaps your health with your sanity in terms of percentage and vice versa. Therefore, you get to decide if you treasure your mind or your body. Just don't try this when wearing nightmare amulet or bone helm, as it will lead to instant death. Next, we have fish cordon bleu. Made with fish and frog legs, the dish allows immunity against wetness. Any existing moisture on body will evaporate immediately, and you'll remain dry for an entire day, allowing you to run free under storm with no worry. Most cheaply made with lesser berries and regular berries, glowberry mousse will quite literally brighten half your day. The light is as bright as a miner hat on head and lantern in hand, which can be replaced with an outfit and tool more fit for journeying into dark. Dragon chili is a result of dragon fruit combined with pepper and can keep your body toasty for one day, helping you during coldest night and killing you during hottest day. For an exact opposite dish, scramble asparagus with ice to get asparagus pacho, which cools your day for a day, making summer days quite bearable. A curious mix of goat horn and honey brings volt goat jelly that increases your damage by packing your punches with lightning spark. Of course, the fisting is even more effective against mobs already wet by nature or by rain. However, this does not amplify attacks that are already charged, and therefore weapons like Morning Star and Electric Dark will not benefit from this jelly. Following dishes don't have special buff, yet may help to know. Potato souffle made with potato and egg is dessert that gives well-balanced hunger and sanity benefits. Monster tartare is Worley's monster lasagna. It looks better and does fill you better, but it's still a failed dish to all but this horrible mutation. Fresh fruit crepe is complicated, yet the best choice to spend your hard-earned butter. Not even waffle can compete in this much gayness. Moqueca is also a more complicated dish using various vegetables, but all in all, worth the trouble. Bon bouillon is another grim dish Worley cooks. The source of those ingredients is quite questionable, but who cares when the meal is actually good. The new vegetables unlock several new recipes for other characters as well. Potato puree, a fancy name for mashed potato, grants decent improvement on health and sanity. Fancy spiral tubers is a sad result of having nothing but ice and potato. Asparagus soup seems healthy appetizer, but you decide if it's worth it. Spicy vegetable stinger is a drink bit tedious, but soothes your mind. Which is like most alcohol, which I really want right now. Banana pop is a cheap, convenient way to regain sanity after crawling around in that dreadful underworld. Ceviche is one way to use fish, although you could swap one fish with a stick for fish sticks, which could be a better option. It does lower your body temperature though. Pepper popper gives nutrition and effect very similar to spicy chili, but simpler to make. Salsa is just like vegetable stinger, but requires more variety in terms of vegetable. Moving on to his portable spicer and blender. The grinder reveals three spices that can be applied to any dish using the blender, and all of them give special buff for half a day. Chili flakes give 20% damage boost. Simple as that. Garlic powder grants additional 33% damage reduction, although it does not decrease damage given to armors. Lastly, honey crystals will decrease the effort you need when mining, chopping, and hammering by 50%, increasing efficiency significantly. When given to right characters, the spices can amplify their strong suits. Wolfgang in his mightiest form can already deal double damage. Feed him a Volt Goat Jelly with chili spice and he receives additional chili buff with electric damage that is greater against wet mobs. Therefore, in current condition, Wolfgang can deal either 360 or 600 damage per blow dart, depending on who he fights. Garlic spice can be given to Wickfred, who already takes 25% less damage for another 33% damage reduction. Therefore, against Berger, who deals 100 damage, Wickfred will now take around 41.5 damage, but that is further decreased when he wears his helm, and the damage is reduced to only 8 damage per strike. As for Honey Crystal, Werebeaver Woody can benefit the most. A single beaver chomp is equivalent to 4 normal axe swings, but with that doubled, he can take down full-grown trees with only 2 bites. Now, since Maxwell's minions do not benefit from this buff, we can agree that Werebeaver High on Sugar can match against Maxwell and his shadow puppets. And here are trivia. Chef Pouch is a portable fridge, another item Worley brought from the realm of Shipwrecked. Quite a bummer, but those two slots went to Insulated Pack, which is more expensive and deadly to acquire, yet available to all characters. The Nightmare Pie works on Wormwood as well, possibly being the only food item he could heal from besides jelly beans. Spices do not work on your followers, so do not bother to give the slaves with something better than they deserve. Though not quite obvious, bone soup will trigger the vegans in cave. Well, to be fair, you may have killed someone for that. And that is all for this new character. Hopefully this video guided you on how to abuse this chef from overseas. And I would like to give my thanks to Kynoox, a fellow Don't Starve YouTuber who chose to share his hard-earned knowledge when I was making this video. He also has several useful videos himself, so do check them out. With that being said, cheers.